All right, week two. This week we're going to Silk City. It's supposed to be a birthday celebration for Rebel Foster. Never seen him play before, but he has a special guest, DJ Aktive. Never seen him play before, but I've only heard good things.
The difference about this week, though, is like last week, I kind of knew DJ Bad. I knew Courtesy a little bit. So like when I got there, I kind of already had a connection to where I was going. Like right now, I don't know anybody at Silk City. Never met Rebel Foster, and I sure as hell have never met DJ Aktive.
First step of the night is the Uber ride. And I thought I was a vlogger that night, but apparently I'm a therapist too.
Learn, like a lot of, I went through a lot of like trials and tribulations, bro. Like you learn, like.
And of course, he was a rapper. You get a one-star review for that, but we made it. The spot is hard to miss. It's a diner on the right side. Then if you go through this door and you make a left, you enter into this. Silk City is super intimate. It's a very small spot, dim lighting. We got one disco ball with two beams of light that are just doing like just the slowest color fade throughout the night. Ambiance. And if you keep going straight past the dance floor, you get to the bar. Rebel Foster was on when I got there, kind of warming up with vibes. But also on early was this guy, Sean Mick. And I'm giving him the edit of the night for this because like, this is like a bag that I don't have in my Serato. Like I don't have these like super mainstream songs with like these just vibey like re-drum remixes that are like, as you can see, setting an ambiance. Really quickly, I kind of realized where I'm at. This is not a mainstream open format top 40 club. And this gets me excited because that means I'm definitely learning something tonight. So I take a spot at the bar, grab my first drink. And by the time I finish that first drink, this place is bubbling. Later, the timestamp on the video says 11:51. Aktive is set up. I have no idea where he came from, but it's starting to feel like the true start to the party.
Thank you.
Quick question for the comments though. Like, do y'all consider Candy a line dance? For me personally, I really try not to play that song unless like somebody comes up specifically to request it, because I feel like it's a cheat code. Like, when you got the right crowd, you know you're gonna get that reaction. Isn't that the same thing as just playing a line dance in the club? Let me know what you think down below. But back to Silk City. Aktive's chirps and stabs are disgusting. And although this is like the counterculture to the mainstream clubs of Center City, Philadelphia, the most interesting part was the songs that actually crossed over that you could kind of play in both those rooms. Also, wait, real quick. This is your reminder. If you have an intro edit of 1-2 step, just delete that. Then you have to play this from the one. And as this night progressed, so did this beautiful roller coaster of a set. What you say? I call your name.
Shit, I'm moving my coat, come in, they gotta use the scale that they weigh the whales with.
All right, so the bathroom is right next to the booth. I have no idea if this is going to be usable or not. So the way Rebel Foster is kind of going about it is he's kind of sprinkling himself in. Like, he's letting his guests kind of, like, dictate at night. And then he kind of hops on, sprinkles a little bit in, hops back off, lets his guests kind of flex. He's on the mic. He's kind of hyping them up. This is a vibe, man. Bad hair day, though.
Come on, Dick. It's my motherfucking birthday, y'all. Thank y'all so much for being here. Listen, sometimes with this DJ shit, I feel like I ain't got it. But y'all show me I got it tonight.
And I'm just one person, I'm just one DJ, and this is the first time I've seen Rebel Foster play. But he's got it, man. Obviously, you can't take everything off of seeing somebody play just once. But with this set, on this night, the dude is fantastic. Especially because when it comes to watching a DJ, the number one thing you can notice, even if it's just your first time watching that DJ, is if he actually genuinely enjoys what he's doing. Like, is he having fun, and does he give a fuck? Rebel does.
Hold on, I gotta give my brother Jabir his flowers. He's such a solid motherfucker. He gifted me a MacBook Pro on my birthday. And he jump-started my DJ career, bro. I love you so much, Jabir. Moral of the story is sometimes you gotta move in silence so people let you know what you did. I love you, bro. Thank you so much.
But now, it's time to close the night.
Before we start to turn it out, you must first begin to
breathe in, breathe out, 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 breathe in, breathe out,
in a row of R&B being the closing sound. And I want to know if that's the formula, but I also want to know, if that's the formula, how can we as DJs take risks even when we're closing. Because at the end of the day, the risks are what sets you apart from every other DJ in your area. But anyways, this is what Silk City looks like with the lights up. I had a great time. I had some great drinks. I Shazammed some things. But now let me give you the closing thoughts after the club.
All right, so I specifically didn't keep my drink count because I got a device. I'm curious. Let's see what my BAC is at.
Calculating. .059.
Not too bad. But I'll tell you what, man. Tonight kind of like really, I mean, every time I go out, I kind of get really inspired. I get really excited to DJ throughout the week. But when I see DJs take risks and play stuff out the box because they know they have the crowd, I feel like that's another level. There's one, like, it's one level to be able to like play for a mainstream crowd, right? It's one thing to play for regular club goers. But what about the anti-scene? The people that don't want to hear the regular stuff. Like, we didn't hear the big hits tonight. We heard the hits that mattered. We heard the hits that were impactful. And like, they went through decades. And that's true up in format. I don't know. I feel like at the end of the day, what it shows me is I have a lot to learn still. I got a lot to add to my crates. I don't have that like Catronata bag at all. That's something I gotta work on. It's inspiring, man. Like, when I see three DJs in a night and they're all disgusting, and it's like not, it's just not even about like, can you cut? It's about, what's your song selection? When are you gonna play that song and why are you gonna play it? What made you think you're gonna play that song? And seeing how DJs work and how they make those decisions, that's the fucking magic. And that's why, like, I don't think I'm gonna get burned out. Like, I already had a lot of people like hit me up already when I posted this on my story promoting the last vlog about like I'm going out 52 weeks in a row, and they're like, no way you make it. You're gonna get burnt out. But man, when I see DJs like this, when I see people that actually give a fuck about the culture like this, it's just motivating. Week two. I have no idea where I'm going next week. We'll figure that out. But this was Silk City, and I'm fucking excited to see where else this year takes us.
How you doing, man?